In Webflow, we can use components to create reusable, consistent layouts across our site. Making changes to one component affects all instances of that component. And if I add properties to a component, designers and editors can change those properties for each component instance. But what if I need one instance of a component to contain a different structure, maybe contain a different type of content? With component slots, you can put a placeholder into a component and decide later, when building your site, what other components to put in that slot. This gives us more flexibility to build a design system for our site that helps us maintain consistency, but also gives us enough flexibility to customize things for different parts of our site. So in this lesson, we'll cover component slots in three steps. First, we'll create and style a slot, then we'll add components to the slot, and finally, we'll show how to adjust any unexpected layout results. In order to create and style slots, you'll need the same access that you need to create and edit components. First step, add a slot to a component and style the slot. Our goal is to create a component that will contain multiple cards, and I want to reuse this component throughout my site. Sometimes this component may contain destination cards. Other times, I may need the slot to have a call to action as well as destination cards. So we want one component that can support both of these scenarios. We already have a component that is a section, a container, and a heading, but it's kind of boring and not very useful. So to make something useful, let's add a slot to our component. First, let's edit the component. The slot element will only be available to add when we're editing a component. Now when we go to the Add panel, we can drag a slot into the component and we'll put it here below the heading within the container. We'll name the slot Card Slot. We don't really have to do that here, but if you use more than one slot, it's easier to distinguish between the slots. And that's the basic structure for our component. Now let's style our slot so that when we later add other components to the slot, they lay out the way we want. First, we'll give our slot a class called Card Slot. Since we want a horizontal card layout, it turns out that some of the defaults are exactly what we need here. The display property is already set to flex, horizontal. And we can configure our X alignment to space around, so that the components we later add will spread out horizontally. We'll set the Y alignment to stretch so that the cards will be the same height once we add them to the slot. And we can also add a little bit of gap between the children components so that they each have some breathing room. And when we're done, we'll just exit from editing the component. That's adding and styling a slot. Let's move on to step two, adding a component to our slot. Now, our component is all ready to use on our site. And once we have an instance of the component on our site, I can just drag any other component into the slot to create a layout that works best for this part of the site. I'll drag in a destination card and duplicate it two more times so we have three destination cards. Well, that looks okay, and the destination cards are exactly the same, but because we designed the destination card component and included properties on the image and each of the text elements, we can change them over in the Properties panel. And this is how we'll customize each card. And with the magic of post-production, we'll update all of the properties on our cards to make three unique destination cards. But what if on another part of the site we want slightly different content? We want a section with two destination cards and a call to action. First, let's add our same destination section component and we'll place it down here. Then we can add two destination cards and one add with a call to action card. And again, we can also change the properties on our destination cards here too. But just like that, within a couple of minutes, we have two different sections with different content using the same destination section component. That's the power of component slots. We get more flexibility to customize what goes into each instance of our component while building our site. But we also still have the consistency of components. If I edit the component and we add a paragraph, you see that this change still updates all instances of the component. So that's how we get consistency and flexibility when using component slots. And now moving on to step three, tuning slot layout. If you run into any issues with the visual results after adding a component to the slot and you're not sure where the styling issue lies, you can check the styling on the slot and then on the child component. If, for example, our cards are not the same height, we often find that the height setting on the slot or the child component is set to something other than auto. And changing the height to auto usually solves that problem, meaning the height will be determined by the content inside. Also keep in mind that this is one way to use slots. We use a single slot to contain three child components. but you could add multiple slots to a component if that suits your design system. So don't be afraid to experiment and find what works best for your site. And that's it. We first created and styled our slots, then we added components to our slot and modified their properties, and finally, we adjusted the styling to ensure our layout looks like we want it to look. That's component slots in Webflow.